To all of you, today we're going to see about how to create interactive e-content using PowerPoint. I'm Dr. B. Yamakumar from Pondicherry Engineering College. So e-content is there is a rapid growth of internet and information technology. So this growth is also made changes in all walks of life, including the education field. So creating a e-content, the e-content should be very interactive for the user and it will be easier for them to learn. So whenever we developing e-content, e-content means any content that is created on the internet, online content. So other than the traditional means, so creating a CD or hosting some content on the net, all the contents you call it as e-content. So the e-content requires a good amount of creativity at the information level as well as the technology level. So it will be a real challenge for facilitators like us to use these resources. So what is the agenda for today? So the main agenda for today, first we are going to see how to create simple animations using PowerPoint. That will be helpful for our day-to-day class lectures. Second, we'll see about what are the basic tricks we can use it whenever we are using PowerPoint. Third one is what are the typical time savers that will be helpful. Okay, so this is one animation that is created using PowerPoint, but we'll not go into these specifics. So each and every shape is created using PowerPoint. So first step, we'll see how to create an animation. So this is the first animation we are going to see. It's a freestyle movement animation. Just observe. So here you have the hand. Once the hand pushes the ball, see the ball gets exactly into the path. You can see it. It goes inside. Okay. Now we'll see how to create this type of animation. So first animation is freestyle movement animation. Okay, I'll just create a new thing. So I'll make it as a blank slide. So what are the components required? You require a ball, you require an hand, and you require this pole. Okay, so we'll create the pole first. So some shapes, make a rectangle shape. Just remove the outline. And I have to create the pole, ball. Create the ball. Pole shape and shape outline. Just fill it up with shape outline. We'll fill it up with some color, the same color that we have chosen, right? Shape fill, I'll just give no fill. Okay, now we have all these things in position. Now we require and. So and image, I can just take it out. Here you have different and images. You can take this image. So always use this particular stepping tool, it will be very useful. I'll just cut this particular part alone that is required for my image. So automatically it will be copied to the clipboard. So I'll just paste it. So it has its outside boundaries. I'll go to format, background removal. So now I got the entire hand. Okay. So now the hand is available. So what is the first animation required? I have to push it. So if I have to go to push it, I'll go to animation. Here you'll have motion paths. So choose this one. So by default it is down. So you go to the effect options, left. Sorry, effect options, you take it right. Right? So it is moving up to this. Up to this is not required. So we'll reduce it up to this ball. So this is the motion path. You can see it. When you click it, it will come and touch the ball. Okay. Now this motion we have to define. So for this motion, again I'll go to the same motion path. I'll choose custom path. This is the custom path I defined. Press escape. That's it. So here I can the duration is fixed. You can see it in the animation pane. So this should react immediately after the hand is pressed. So you have to put after previous. Okay. So it will be like this. Once I give a press, this ball will move inside that thing. Okay, that's a simpler animation. So now this is complete. Okay, this is the first animation we have seen how to create by using motion paths. So you can create any motion paths literally according to your requirement. Okay, so we'll get back now the second one. So I have actually added a sound. If required, you can add a sound, or else sound is not option. So you can have audio. So audio on my PC. So you can add music files that you have, anything. Okay, so that sound can be added. We'll move on to the next one. Okay, so this is a very interesting one. This one is called as flow animation. So suppose you are explaining a flow of different things. So the first thing that comes, then the second one, then the third one, and so on. Okay. So this is called as a flow animation. We'll see how to create this flow animation. So take the shape. Choose no outline. Fill it up with a color of choice. Next, I'll take another shape. And the arrow. Take an arrow, so fill it up with and no outline. Shape, choose a rectangle. Shape outline, no. Shape fill with the same color. Suppose you are not able to identify that color, use this eyedropper and select the color you want. Okay. So now we have got this one. Next, we will create the circles. So choose a circle. So this is the first one. Now we'll group the entire content. Let's Control G, okay, and make a duplicate copy of it. So this should be of different color, say green color. We'll ungroup this. Because we require this on the top. And this has to go back. So send to back. Right? Now we'll group this one. Now duplicate this part. Fill it up with other color. Send to back. Control D is a shortcut for duplicate. Send to back. Want some content here, so I'll just put a point. I'll increase its size. Use some other font. We'll choose yet another color. So this way it will be useful. Now we'll go for the animation part. So animation, this has to be wiping away. I'll give from left. Then this should also wipe from left. This should also wipe from left. This is again wipe from left. Very simple animation. First point, second, third, Okay, this will be helpful for explaining a flow. So to get the flow still more thing, you can increase the timing. So I can go for effect options. So by timing default, it is 0.5 seconds, very fast. Say I'll get a medium, 2 seconds. So that will be, so here itself you can increase the timing. Move your cursor, it will show you this particular symbol. So move it to 2 seconds. That's fine. Now you see the animation. So the first point, then you will be explaining the second point, then the flow, third point, then the fourth point. Here you can add additional text also. Okay, this is our second animation. So coming back to our presentation, so this is another interesting animation. It's called as a sand clock animation. You can see the black sand here. Once I give click, the sand fills in. Okay, this is a clock animation. We'll see how to achieve this sand clock animation. So for this you require two triangles. Click the first one. This is the sand. So I'll fill it up with any color that I require, any color sand I require. Shape outline, no. Okay. So I'll make a duplicate of it. So this one. Black color. Shape fill. No fill. Effect shape outline, I can just increase the weightage, just bring it over here, and I'll take another shape, rectangle shape. I'll just smooth the edges by using this yellow dot over here. So this I will again fill it up with same color that we have filled up. Shape outline is black, shape fill is this one. So this is my base. Okay, now this we'll just group it. So I will now get a copy of this. Just rotate it. Keep it on the top. Now we have got the sand clock contents. Now we will insert a rectangle shape exactly from this point. Exactly, we will move it to the center. Okay, so if you are unable to do it with the mouse, you can just use the up arrows and down arrows to fill it up. This shape is also to be, this is a sand, so I will fill it up with the same color and I will remove the outline. Okay, now what is the direction of this one? In which direction it has to go? It has to move down. I will go to the animation, this one. It has to So first this has to go down. So we'll select this one. First we'll group these contents, that it will be easy for us to identify the exact one. We'll choose this one. It has to wipe. In which direction it has to wipe? From top. From top, it has to wipe. Next, we'll choose this one. This we'll choose it from exit wipe. In which direction it has to? From top. So this has to be with the previous. Similarly, this particular one, this is wipe, this is from bottom. This is from bottom. This also is with previous. So now the animation. Okay. So the thing is that this has to move away. So we'll use wipe. So we'll use wipe. I've increased the time duration to 2 seconds. Next one is this particular. This is an entrance effect. This is an exit effect. So from here in exit, you have to choose wipe. This has to go down. So I'll choose in the effect option from top. Second is this one, this rectangle. It is also wipe option, but it is from, again from top. This is again for 2 seconds. This is also wipe option. This is from bottom. From bottom, it is wipe option. All these three have to happen simultaneously. So here I'll just click start with previous. Normally it will be with start on click. You'll put start with previous. This is also start with previous. Now if you see, if I click, this is the initial phase. Okay, the final phase, it has to be filled over here, the transition phase. So as I click, this is the option that will be getting up. Okay, so this is how you create the sand clock animation. This will also quite look. Yes. Okay, so we move on to the animation thing. We'll come back to the next animation, clock effect animation. You can see this clock effect that we initially showed in our title slide also. Here we are actually showing it for 5 points. We'll give the explanation with 3 points, then it is possible to build it. Okay, we'll get back. The fourth animation we are going to see is clock effect animation. So to get the clock effect animation, I'll insert isosceles triangle. So normally if you rotate this object, you can see the center point, it moves about the center point. This is the center point. Okay, but if you see in the animation, this is actually rotating about this central point. Okay, this center, this point is fixed. Fine. So how to create that effect, how to switch the center from ear to ear to ear from this point. So to convert that center, what I'm going to do is I just do Ctrl D. I'll get a duplicate of this shape fill. I'll remove the outline. I'll just take it, make it rotate 90 degrees, and just I will attach it to here. Now we'll group this together. The shortcut is Ctrl G. Now if you see, it is rotating about the center. Now if I move this over here, keep it in the center, you can see the movement looks like it is in the center only. Okay, so that this is the trick. Now we'll take this part. This part, I'll just give no outline. I'll also give no fill. Now it literally looks like only one half is there. Now I'll also insert a small shape, so to give a look of an arrow. So this one, again I'll give no outline. I'll fill it up with a red color, so we can give some shape effects. So I can give a small bevel, so that will be very interesting. Similarly, this one will give a bevel. Shape effect and give a shadow. If we want, we can change it to some other color. This is nice. Okay. Now we have this arrow. I'll group it. Now this is a single entity. Now if you rotate it, it will be rotating about the center. Now just keep it here. Now you can see it is rotating about the center. Okay, so now we'll keep it at our desired location according to the points. Say I'm going to have only 3 points. So now I'll insert an arc. In shapes you choose arc. Okay, preferably I'll have it as some black color. Just keep it over here. Expand it. Again, fix it. Just extend the yellow part and see the rotation goes beyond here. Here we can just expand it to accommodate the pointer. Again we'll just see here, we can make it down. That's it. So the movement is free. Now we'll fix it in one position. So this position, what I require is, I require another bullet to come in. So I'll take shape, I'll take a circle, I'll just the circle here. So I'll outline, no outline, I'll fill it up with, okay, this blue color. Then shape effects, again I can give a shadow effect as well as I can give a bevel effect. So now this is my first one. So here I'll just click say first point. So select the particular thing and increase its size to say 40, and I can just give a font that I want. Okay, now this is my thing. Now it has to go according to the thing, so increments. So you'll go to your select, format, size. Okay, here you can see it is at 46 degrees. Here it is at 46 degrees. So if I move it here, it is 90 degrees. So 46 plus 50. 54. 46 plus 54 is 90. Sorry, 44. 44. Okay, another 44, you'll get this one. So this point, if I give another 90 plus 44, 134, it will come over here. Okay, so I'm adding 44 degrees, it will be in this position. In this position, I'll just keep a marker so it will be easier for us to identify this position. This is just a marker. Again, I'll give another rotation for this 134. So again, this position I give a marker. This is just exactly to know the position. Okay. Now I'll bring it back to the original position. So it is at 46 degrees. Now I'll just copy paste this particular thing. Once we are in the position, we'll remove these lines. These lines are only for reference. This 2. This 3. Now we want to make this one animate. We'll go to animation. First we'll add this animation. For this one we'll add the animation as just wipe. So by default it is from bottom. Okay, I have the animation pane. Now this is in the bottom. Once this comes, this particular object has to come. So here I'll just give it as shape, or else we can give it say zoom. Okay, when this is to come, immediately after the arrow comes it has, so start after previous, immediately this comes, this will come. Okay, now this has to move, so I have to add animation to this one. So you have add animation. So again I'll give, can give, see, spin. If I give a spin action, it is actually going for 360 degree rotation. So rather I'll go to the effect options. You see it is 360 degree clockwise. It will give how much rotation I want from 46. It is in 46. I require 44 degree. Press enter and then give OK. Now it will come to the second position. Once it is in this position, we have to make this one appear. So for that we'll again give a zoom. So this is for the second one. So this zoom should start with the previous or after the previous. After this arrow comes, this should come. Okay, then third point, this should go to the ear. Okay, so add animation, spin. By default it is again 360 degree. Go to the effect options, go to custom, change it to 44 degrees. So it will be 44 degree from that position. Here it will not be showing, but you can see it later. Then once this comes, this has to be zoom. This should come after previous. Okay, now we'll see the full animation. So the first point, second point, third. Okay, so this is how you create your bullets. So this is an interesting way to obtain the attention of the people. So this is called as clock effect animation. So next one is an user interactive animation. You can see here only these blocks. Suppose you are using it for explanation in the class, so you can just click. So this will give you this. So this will give you a click, give you the thing. So all these things you can trigger it. So this will be an interactive animation. We'll see how to click and create this particular thing. We'll take the same diagram just for your understanding. So this is a frontal lobe, parietal lobe, temporal lobe, occipital lobe. So I'll insert shape, so oval. So shape fill, I'll use gradient fill. So shape outline, no outline. Also I can give a bevel effect of so here I can give say 1. It's up to you to give the content. So here I'll just use some other font, say Algerian. Use a different color, say this one. Bold. 40. Okay, this is my first one. I'll just Control P. Second, third, fourth. This I'll just rename 2. This I'll rename 3. This I'll rename 4. Now we have got the main things. Now we have to add contents. Again, I'll go to shape. I'll choose a rectangle with round corners. So here we can just smooth the edges. We want the exact size as that one. Okay. So this is the thing. So again I'll do a shape outline, no outline. I'll fill it with the same gradient color. Say this one. And we'll use the same effect. So bevel effect. If you want, you can also add a shadow effect. Okay, so what should come here? So this is temporal lobe. So use font red. Font is Algerian. Is 40. Okay, this is a temporal lobe. I'll just copy paste this one. Once the objects are in position, and just group it so that it does not get altered. So this one, make another copy. So this is frontal lobe. This one is parietal lobe. This one is occipital lobe. Okay, now this is as such in the figure, but we want to animate this one. When I click this one, this should come. Okay, so first you have to identify what is the name for this particular round. So in home page, home tab, go to select, go to selection pane. OK, can see vowel 2. Vowel 2 you can even rename it as 1. So vowel 3, vowel 4 it is actually, so I rename it as 3. This is vowel 5, so I'll rename it to 4. This is vowel 3, I'll rename it to 2. Okay, this is the selection pane. So I'll get back to the animation zone. So I'll just click on this one, add animation. It should wipe from left. I'll take the effect options. In effect options, you can see in the timing, you have something called as trigger. So start effect, click on it. When it comes to, okay, so it is a group. So I just regroup, ungroup this one, so that each one will be separate. We'll come back to this effect option. So timing, trigger, when it should trigger, when 1 is pressed. So 1 is pressed, it should come out. Okay, similarly if 1 is pressed, it has to go out. Fine. So I'll just another animation for the same, add animation. It should wipe from right. Okay, this should come with the trigger. Okay, now we'll see how it looks. I click 1, this will come. If I again click 1, so this particular thing, this wipe, click, made the reverse. So the first one, it should go from left. Okay, the second one, it should go from right. To give it a gradual, we'll make it to 1 second. So you can see it over here. I click. Here, the second effect, remove it. The second effect should be removing effect. So you take it from wipe from exit. Okay, in what way it has to exist? From right. Okay, now you can see that effect. I'll remove the animation, we made a small mistake here. The first one is, it should wipe from left. It should wipe from left when we press it. So effect options, choose timing, triggers as part of 1. Okay. Next one is, for the same object, press add animation, from exit you choose wipe. So this wipe has to be from right. That's it. Now this should be with the trigger. Just I will add it to trigger 1. So now if I see, if I press 1, this will come. If I again press 1, this will vanish. The same animation you can just copy to others also. Okay. So you click on it. Animation painter. Okay. Only thing, this will not have the trigger, so we'll add the trigger effect options, timing, triggers, part of 4. So this will also coming under 4. So if I click on 1, it will show you. Again it click, it goes 4. If I click, it will show. Again if I click, it will go. So in the same way you can do it for the other contents also. So this is user interactive animation. Okay. So the next one is open envelope animation. You can see this very quite envelope opens and your content comes out. We'll see how to do this open envelope animation. Insert. First a shape, we'll take a rectangle. Next, we'll create another triangle. This should be slightly smaller than the previous one. This preferably I'll give a color, a light color. Use more fill colors. I'll choose lighter color and no outline. Similarly for the outer also, no outline. Okay. Now we'll choose insert a shape triangle. Now for the covers, I'll choose an isosceles triangle. I'll just rotate it, just keep it in position and decrease its size so that it is almost in the center. Okay. Now we have this triangle. Again I'll remove the outline, so we can even have it slightly darker shape free. Slightly dark. Okay. So now I require a copy of this one. I'll just rotate it 180 degree. I'll be able to achieve it easily. Again, I'll get one more copy. Rotate it. Just keep it in the point, drag it up to the edge and reduce it. Now this is in position. Now the same one, I'll just get a copy of it. This, I'll just keep it over here. So this should be having the same color as that of the inner one. So I'll fill it up with this color. So no outline, and a small gap. You can use the arrow to make it down. And the same one, I require another copy. Or you take this one, Control B. This is for closing cover. Okay, now my get an effect, you will just increase it. Okay, now the cover is ready. Now go to the selection pane. You can see this object isosceles triangle. For the time being, I will hide it. Now I have this particular content. This is my text. So I'll select the text. This one. Insert the shapes. I'll have a basic shape, text boss. Just put it outside. This is my text. Choose it. Increase the font size. Use and written format. I'll use winner inbuilt font, winner ITC. This is my text. I'll just move it to the top right corner. Okay. The text along with the background, I will group it. This should come inside. It. Now this is my text. Now I have to do the animation. Bring it to front. Okay. I have to do the animation for this part. What is the animation? This has to move up. It has to move up. So I'll use exit, okay, and we'll use so to give the animation effect. First, I'll choose this part. So I'll add the animation. I'll take more exit effects. I'll choose collapse. So effect option is from to the top. So it should collapse to the top. Similarly, this one, I'll add animation, more entrance effects. I'll use moderate stretch. Again, I'll use effect options from bottom. Now we can see, if I click, it happens, but this should happen automatically. So after previous, now if you see, click, it will open up. Now once it opens up, this should come out. Okay, this particular card should pop up. So I'll add animation for that. I'll use a motion lines. So by default it is going down. I choose an option up, it comes up, it pops up. Okay, so when this should happen? After previous, should do after previous. Okay, now we'll see the effect. The text pops up. That's it. So this is called as, again we can show this one. That's how my animation looks like. This is how to create an envelope effect. Fine. So now for some of the basic tips for teaching. So this is the first technique called shift the focus technique. See here, this is the first point, this is the second point, this is the third point. You can see whenever I go for the next point, the other things becomes dark. So this is the way you shift the focus to your point of attention. So how to create this particular animation? This might first remove all the animation. So I have to give the effect. I'll just give wipe from left on click. So first click, this will come, second this will come, third will come. Okay, now the interesting part, you go to here, effect options, you choose, after that you like to dim it with this color. Similarly for this one, after effect you dim with this color. Similarly, third one, after explanation, it dims. Now, this is the way you present it. This is the first point, the second point, this is the third point. Okay. So, the next interesting technique is zoom the point trick. We have to give emphasis on the point. So this is the first point you are explaining. After the first point, my second point should zoom, the first should come back to its normal. Again, third point should come, second should go to the normal. Okay, so how to achieve this particular thing? So I'll remove all animation. Again, I'll choose wipe from left. Okay, from left I'll choose a wipe animation. Here I have to zoom it. Okay, so here you can just choose zoom. The zoom effect looks like this. Zoom effect. Rather, we'll use grow and shrink effect. See, it zooms. Let's remove the animation. I want for each and every one, I'll use grow and shrink. Okay, on click, each one will be separate. Now I add again grow and shrink, but this time I'm going to go to the effect options. See the size, you can see it is 150%. I just type 67%. Okay. Okay, that's fine. Now, when the first, when the second comes, your first should reduce by 67%. It should happen automatically. It should stop. When the fourth comes, this should happen with previous. Okay. Now we'll see what it looks like. This is the first point, second point, third point. Okay. So this is how you zoom the focus, zoom the point trick. So play in reverse order trick. Suppose you are giving a list of factors that are responsible. So most reduced effect factor first, then what is the second factor, the most important factor you introduce last. So for that you can go for reverse order. So it has a basic wipe effect. So let's remove the animation first and delete all the animations. Okay. Now I'll choose the entire test boss together. Entire test boss. I'll use the wipe effect. I'll choose effect options. Test animation. You keep by first level paragraph in reverse order. That's it. So first point, second point, third point. So this is putting in reverse order. The fourth interesting method is stop animation in one go. Suppose you have good number of animation in a slide. Every time, suppose you don't want animations, you go delete all the things, and suppose again I require back all the animation, it will be very tedious task. So an interesting way is go to slideshow, go to setup slideshow, show without animation. Okay, so now if you present it, there will not be any animation. And again, if you want to get back your animation, you switch off this particular thing. Okay, so you'll get back all your animation. So this is another useful trick. Stop all animation in one go. Okay, so now for some time saver tips. Double click to select a word, triple click to select a paragraph. Suppose I want to select one word. Normally we'll be dragging like this, but sometimes it will not be easier to drag it. So double click to select a word, triple click to select a paragraph. It's a very easy tip. Second tip, hold Control and Shift. Normally to get a copy of it, you press Control D. Okay. Or you can also use press the control and drag it. So if you drag it, it will come in all possible directions. Okay. Rather, you press control shift and then drag it. You will not get any direction, it will come only in straight line. See, this particular object, control shift, it can come only in a straight line. So this is an interesting way to drag it in a straight line. So this is another interesting topic, control D. You think to draw this particular equal line spacing, it will be a very difficult task. I'll just remove this content. See how to create this in just a fraction of a second. I'll just create a rectangle. Okay. Now press control D. Just align it once. Then again you press control D, it will automatically preserve the same time spacing. Similarly, take another shape. Control D is for duplicate. Okay, so once you kept the spacing, then again you will get just with the same spacing. See, it just finished in a fraction of a second. Okay, so this is the power of Control D. That's called for smart copying. Fourth one is how to crop to aspect ratio for full page photograph. This is actually a full page photograph. So initially I'll take this picture. So normally if you insert this picture, you see, so what we'll do is that we'll extend it, or the quality of the image will get. So a better option is go to format, crop, crop by aspect ratio. So this is a wide screen, so it is 16:9. So crop for 16:9. Now it is cropped for that particular thing. You can just move it, drag up to the limits, and I'll send it to back. Okay, so let's use crop to aspect ratio for full page photos. Next, use lock drawing mode to use an auto shape. Okay, see, normally when you want to draw something, so you have a shape. So I want to draw an object like this. If we want to add a shape, we'll be just drawing, dragging, dropping. Okay, it will be very difficult. So rather we have an interesting feature: insert, shapes, I'll just show it over here. I'll create shapes, three rectangles. Connect these boxes, so I can use shape. Okay, again I have to go to shape. I have to take another elbow. See, it will come in all different possibilities. So to remove that particular thing, insert, shape, here you right click, lock drawing mode. Can create like this. Okay, so this will be, you will not go and drag, bring it again and again. So next, other tips are, place all your frequently used tools in quick access toolbar. So this is your quick access, whatever you want. Suppose you are frequently using a add to quick access, so here it will be available, so it will be easier for you to use from this. That's second thing. Another tip is use tell me what to you want to do. You have a tool, most of you might not identify this. So here suppose I want edit font, so replace test fonts, all those things it will come here, so it will automatically show you all the content. Say I want word art, I don't know where word art is, so automatically if you click it, it will show you where. And this one is to switch between PowerPoints. So currently I'm using two PowerPoints here, so if I use Control Tab, it will move to the second PowerPoint. So this is how things. Place all your frequently used tools in quick access toolbar. Tell me what you have, what you want to do tool to find a tool fast. Use Control plus Tab to switch between PowerPoint windows. So that's it. Thank you. Thank you very much.